Hi everyone, my name is Brian and I'm the 3D print creator. In this episode we are going to talk about the Anet E10, which is right behind me. And it's a printer I've been working on a lot. I have this printer now for 1.5 weeks. And my first result out of the box, they started very nice, but they soon became very, very bad. And this had everything to do with screws coming loose, with, well, the mechanical structure of the printer was really bad out of the box. So then I have been tightening screws, I've been tightening belts, and I've made the printer a bit better. And I retried things, and well, it got better, but it didn't get perfect. Then I updated my printer, as you can see here in the link somewhere here. And that was my latest video, and there you saw me using Mr. Cranky Faces updates and CNC Kitchens updates. I'll link to them in the description down below. And with their upgrades to this printer, I made it really mechanical okay. So now the printer is pretty much okay. There is one thing I would rather change. I would change the bars that are used, which are now T-slots and which should be V-slots. But for now it's pretty much okay. And well, I've been filming all the way through all the things I've been doing, the printing of benches. So my first benchy was this one, and you can see it's got a lot of strings. This is really a horrible benchy. This was, I think, the second or third print I made with this printer. And I made a few others and they became better slightly, but not perfect. Until I was done with the upgrade you saw in the latest video, and then this benchy came out. This was all before I made a profile for Simplify 3D that was really that was set to the correct settings, because I think you have to tinker the profile to get the most out of your printer, and I think this goes for every printer, so also for this one. So I've been tinkering on my profile, but I've not yet printed the benchy, and at the end of this video you will see me printing a benchy with these settings. So what I've made so far with an optimized profile is this holster for my Glock Airsoft pistol, and this is a really nice I think it's a really nice print. You can see that it's got no stringing at all. It's very decent and very detailed, and this is really my first real decent print that came out of the printer, something that I'm really liking, because this has a very, very good quality. So now I'm going to take you guys into my profile settings for Simplify 3D, because I want to share my settings and show you guys what I've done. So here is my Simplify 3D, and I will zoom in a little bit at the FFF settings. So here we are, and here you can see my profile, and as you can see under the selected profile here, you see Anet E10. It's a profile I made especially for this machine. It's a PLA profile, and I have the infill set at 33%, but we will see that later on. Now I've got my nozzle diameter set at 0.40, which is the correct nozzle size. The extrusion multiplier is at 0.90. And then I've the manual setting for the extrusion width, because if you use the automated setting, then you will see it will choose 0.48. And I don't like it. At 0.48, it's just too much. So at 0.40, it gives you a real nice setting, and this is really what you should use. Then I've got my retraction turned on, and the retraction distance is at 5 millimeters, so it retracts 5 millimeters every time I'm retracting the filament from the nozzle. And there is an extra restart distance of -0.20. So this will make sure that there are no little oozes out of the nozzle just before it stops and starts retracting. Then the retraction speed is set at 45 millimeters a second. This is a normal speed for this printer and for a Boden extruder. Then my layer settings. Well, I'm printing a Benchy, so at this moment I've got my extruder settings at 0.20 millimeters with the top, the bottom and the outline layers set to 3. And I'm printing from the inside out. And I'm using optimized start points. This gives me a faster printing speed. Maybe the quality would be a little better if I use randomized start points, but as you will see, the quality for this print will be perfect. Then the first layer height is just at 100%. I don't change my first layer height, but I do change my first layer width. I've changed it to 110%, and my first layer speed is set at 50%. So this is an important setting if you're printing with this this fake Bultec that is supported with the printer. I use a skirt or a brim, how you want to call it, and the main reason I use this is I found out that when I'm printing with this printer, it tends to it needs about 5 or 6 centimeters before it really starts oozing filament. So I'll give it a few rounds around the object it's going to print, just to make sure that it's oozing filament at the moment I need it. So therefore I use this. There is no other reason. This is the only reason I use it. All the other things are turned off, and now we go to the infill. I used to print with 33% infill a lot. This gives a great mechanical structure, as you will see, for example, in the holster I printed. The mechanical structure is really, really good, and I tend to like this. Then there is no support needed in the Benchy, so the support will be off. The temperature, well, for the heated bed, you have to select a temperature of 50 degrees Celsius. If you're using the material that came with the printer, it's a fake Bultec, but I really like how it sticks. I have to say it sticks pretty darn well. So I really love this material, although I must say that when it's worn out, I will switch to glass, because I like printing on glass more than I like printing on Bultec material. So I will switch to glass, but for now, I'll use this material. There is a reason why on a larger print bed like this is, you don't want to print with a Bultec surface. And that reason is that your bed will warp. It's a large bed and it will warp. So therefore I will go using glass, because glass is always straight. Now for the temperature of the nozzle, I can give you my temperature, but really you need to set this yourself for your type of PLA. For my type of PLA, I know that 207 degrees Celsius is the correct temperature, but you need to set it for your own PLA. Then for the cooling. At the first layer I don't use the cooling fan, at the second layer I use it at full speed, and this is for this print great. It worked very good. Now for the G-code, well, I've only set the settings for this printer. I didn't do anything else, and I've a script made that when the printer starts it homes all axes, and when the printer ends it turns off the extruder, it turns off the bed. Then it homes the X and the Y axis, so I don't use G28 solely, because then it also will home the Z axis, and you don't want that to happen. So I'm only homing the X and the Y axis. And this is very nice, because then your nozzle won't stay at the top of your print. And then after everything is done with M84, I'm disabling all the motors. So the ending script, it's a pretty important script. Then for the speeds, well, for the Benji I tend to print at 40 millimeters a second because I did it on all the Benjis I printed. This printer can easily print 60 or even more millimeters a second, but for now I'm printing 40 millimeters a second because I did so on all the other prints. My outline underspeed is set to 80%, also because I do this on all the Benjis, because I want to have something to compare. But normally, I must say, I'm printing with an outline underspeed of 100%, because it really speeds up the print. This is a setting that can really determine how long your print takes. Solid infill underspeed is also 100%. Support structure underspeed is 80%. And, well, here I have the speed overrides when the printing speed for the layer is below 15 seconds. And then I allow it to go down to 20% maximum. This is just when you're printing, for example, the chimney on top of the Benji, then one layer takes only 2 seconds. So then the other layer will be dropped on top of it, and this will make it slower, so it has time to cool down, and it will print a very, very nice chimney on top of the Benji. Then on the other settings, well, actually I don't set this except for the bridging speed multiplier, which is 120%, because if you make the movement a little faster for bridging, then you will see that your filament won't hang down. And I set the prices for my filament just for calculations. And also here on this advanced tab, well, I don't use it except when I'm having different settings for different heights in the print, then you will use this part here. But at this moment I'm not going to use it. So this is it. These are my settings I'm using for the Anet E10. Now we will go and print the 3D Benji and see what the result is. So now we will see what the result is of this setting for the 3D Benji. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, if you didn't like it, give it a thumbs down, but also please give a comment so I know what you didn't like about the video. If you're not subscribed to the channel, well, please subscribe and also use the bell button to get notified every time I make a new video. And know that if you're an Anet E10 user, there is a special playlist on my YouTube channel for the Anet E10, and also on my website you will find all the information structured, so that if you have an Anet E10 you can find all the information there, or if you have the DaVinci Pro machine you can find all the information there, because I've structured it on my website. Well, this is it. If you want to help out this channel, please do so by buying me a cup of coffee or becoming a Patreon. The links therefore are in the description down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.